Hello everyone, and welcome back to Dishonored 2. Now, if you're looking at this and you've seen the end of the last episode, we're wondering why is the completion time different and the detections and everything different? It's because my sieve corrupted. So I lost everything and I had to redo the past four missions. So yeah, I think we did a little bit better than last time. It's just I missed like four blueprints. And we did the non-lethal takedown. Still somehow got high chaos, but meh. And we killed the leader of the Howlers, which is that Paolo guy. So I had to redo it. I decided to kill him. Meh. So that's why the stuff is all different. And yeah, let's see what happens just now after we've got Sokolov back. Another strange visit. We're not having another chat with the bloody outsider, are we? It's very rare he greets us twice within four missions. Alright, you've awakened with a strange feeling. Weaky, weaky. What, this is different? I don't remember trees in the void.
The void again, but it feels different.
Yeah. Yeah, this ain't the void. This is some weird fucked up version of the void.
Surprised I can pull you into this place? The outsider marked me long ago. I made you flee your precious tower and turned Emily into cold stone. How difficult for you. But when I was young, sweet Jessamine and I were closer sisters, sharing a secret. Emperor Caldwin had another daughter, born in shame to a kitchen maid.
What's she playing at? Maybe how is the question?
Yeah, how's that? No, right. Sorry, I keep doing this. Noise, that just happens. But in the first game, in the DLCs, we played as Dowd. In the first DLC, Knife of Dunwall, you heard about Delilah. The outsider mentioned it to you. And then you go and find out who she is and all this fun stuff. In the second one, you actually hunt her down and kill her. You kill her in the void. Because in the first one, in the DLC, she planned to remove kid Emily's soul. So Emily, during the time of the first one when she was a kid, she planned to remove her soul and lived as her through her eyes. Now, Dowd, respectively, the assassin who killed Emily's mother, saved her. So Delilah went into the void to do this thing. Dowd stabbed her in the heart and then stabbed her in the face. Like, straight through the face. So maybe it's because she died in the void and now that she's back she can pull us into the void? I don't know. This is creepy. Like, the void with the exit on it is creepy enough. This is creepier.
games in the tower. But at night, I'd go back to the servants' quarters with cockroaches and thin gruel. Emperor Daddy would visit and tell me if I was good. Next year, I'd be old enough to come to court to be a princess. Then one day, Pretty Jessamine broke something worth a fortune, and the spymaster caught us. She claimed I did it, and he whipped me in the garden house until I bled. My mother lost her kitchen job, and that night we were out on the streets with no place to sleep.
So you just...
I didn't break it.
Fuck seekings for children. Just say it was an accident. We both kind of broke it because we were playing. That's a fucking shit, bollocks.
Mother and I saw the nastiest parts of Dunwall, ending up in debtor's prison. Jessamine died quick on an assassin's blade, but my mother lingered for weeks after a fat guard broke her jaw. They threw me out when she died. I looked up at the lights of Dunwall Tower and swore revenge. Washing bedsheets in a brothel, I painted on the side until Anton Sokolov took me as a student. That's the polite word for it. I was crafty even before the outsider marked me and survived the worst the Empire could offer. Now it's your turn.
I hear you. Oh, wrong button.
How much of this is true, and how much is Delilah's warped imagination?
Probably half of it's Delilah's warped imagination. It's Delilah. She probably went mad in the void. Right, we are back now to normal. Meet with Megan and Anton to discuss the next steps in your effort to take down Delilah and the Duke of Sarkonos. On. I pressed A and you don't load.
When I saw what they'd done to Anton Sokolov, I wanted to hurt everyone who'd helped Delilah and the Duke of Sarkonos pull off their coup. Sokolov is the man who made whale oil into a weapon, who turned back the plague, and now he's barely able to speak. The hands that painted the most powerful men and women of our time shake too badly to hold a spoon. When he does talk, he's going to give me a name. The next step along the way to Duke Luca Abel. Then Delilah herself.
That bit was not talking.
A name. That's all I need.
Right. I didn't mean to interrupt that cutscene. But that bit, bloody Sokolov opened his eyeballs, is creepy. And I hear things. Oh.
I'm with you, even in the void. If only I could do more.
Jessamine, Delilah's stronger now.
Am I to blame for Delilah's bitterness?
All this is her doing, and she'll die for it.
Our decisions have weight. I feel my time drawing to an end. Soon.
Oh, Grumpy also got up there. This, thank you. It's something I should say to your face, but that's hard for me. Thank you for what you did bringing Anton back. What would I have done without him puttering around the ship, mumbling and stroking his greasy beard? I wanted to find him on my own, but hearing what you went through, I'm impressed. Anyway, enjoy this bottle from the captain's reserve. Good stuff I got from an aristocrat. Wanting quick passage of Karnaca a while back. Only did now that Anton is back. If you want to sleep, his snoring cuts straight through the bulkhead, which is that bottle there. Sad you actually can't drink it. Right, let's go see what's going on.
Somewhere in the world is beating a servant. He is but a boy. The beating will leave him. lie. He was late with the tea.
That's a bit harsh.
For a man of his age, Sokolov's making better progress than I would have expected.
You're still here. Oh, Jesus, no. Put it down. Put it down. Thank you, Jesus. Turn the burner off.
There you are, Corvo. I've been treating Anton.
Good to see that you're still with us. Thank you for helping Anton.
Sokolov's not the only one making a rapid recovery. I'll be good enough to leave soon. There's a lot to do. Of course, unless the Duke falls, he'll undo my best efforts here.
I'm working on that. Believe me, the Duke has my full attention.
Karnaka's key leaders are flawed for certain. After all this is settled with the Duke, and the time of the coup has passed, whichever ones are left standing could change things here. Consider that, as you come face to face with the Duke's remaining associates.
Maybe, Alexandria, but sometimes your friends dictate your fate.
Right.
Corvo.
Ah, the Royal Protector has risen. A bad night? Maybe you've been sleeping on goose feathers too long.
Sit down when you want to talk.
Grumpy old mother trooper.
Delilah Copperspoon. Or is it Caldwin?
Oh. The door's locked annoyingly. Hey, let's just start this briefing. Let's go.
Anton, you've had 3 days to rest. Tell me how to kill Delilah.
They tortured him. His body is covered with bruises.
Delilah has the throne, and she has Emily. Anton, once we had you in a cage and you dared us to kill you, I need that man back.
I remember that.
She's right. I can make electricity move from one side of the room to the other, but Delilah is beyond my understanding. When I came to Sirkonos, I meant to leave everything behind. But when the assassination started, I couldn't ignore it. By the time Megan and I connected the murders to the Duke, it was too late. The Crown Killer came for me. It kept me alive from my knowledge, but I saw things. Jindosh often had a visitor, Brianna Ashworth.
The curator of the Royal Conservatory.
Yes. Ashworth is dangerous, as obsessed with the occult as Delilah. Apparently, she's working on a device called the Oraculum.
There's more to her than either of you know.
If Ashworth is one of Delilah's lieutenants, I need to eliminate her. Who knows what this device is capable of, or what she's up to.
Okay. Oh, what's this? Temporary closures. Right, the operations due to an alarming increase in the mite population. And with all the knowledge and approval of Duke Abad himself, the Royal Conservatory will remain closed for the foreseeable future. Our apologies. Brianna Ashworth, curator.
Shuttered to the public. Wonder what's going on inside the Royal Conservatory. The Duke's incompetence? Or something more suspicious. The closest path to the Royal Conservatory should be through Syria Gardens.
Which I'm guessing you've been to, Corvo. But let's go off to the skiff now.
We'll take the skiff. I don't want to bring the dreadful whale any closer than we have to. There is a small dock in Syria Gardens, close to the conservatory. That's as far as I can take you.
Understandable.
Ready to go?
Yep. Oh god, that's very glitchy looking.
Yes, let's go.
Right, the Royal Conservatory, while held captive, Anton Sokolov learned the identity of one of Delilah's chief allies, Brenna Ashworth, an architect of the coup that helped that took the throne in Dunwall. Ashworth is powerful and full of secrets. She's building a mysterious device for Delilah. Brenna Ashworth must be eliminated. I can't bloody read to save my life. Taking your time to load. I'm probably going to cut out a large chunk of me looking. I'll probably just do me looking for stuff, doing the main stuff basically in the observatory, because I'll probably cut out me looking for bone charms and stuff, so the video isn't too long.
There'll be a grand guard presence outside the Royal Conservatory. Inside, be prepared for anything. Ashworth runs with an eclectic crowd. They'll be the real danger.
Someday I'd like to know more about how you met Ashworth.
I know you would. Trust me, Ashworth is important to Delilah. Which brings up something else. You might be able to exploit the Abbey of the Everyman in removing Ashworth from play. Turns out the Vice Overseer in Karnaca has been watching Ashworth from a hidden outpost near the Royal Conservatory. Check it out first if you want more options. Remember, if she's still working with Delilah, Ashworth is a grave threat.
Thanks, Megan. See you soon.
Okay, let's go.
Long as it takes. We'll be picking up balusters and spindles made of zirconian umberwood.
I thought the old Duke Theodanus outlawed umberwood export to protect the trees.
I can't keep track of all the decrees. My client's refurbishing her gazebo, adding an exotic southern touch.
I don't get it.
All right, dude, calm down.
I brought back a river cross shell to use as an ashtray.
Holy fuck.
So what's
the mind of bone charms. Okay, sir.
Lady sure she has money, so she gets the wood she wants.
Will you stop complaining?
Wait, this isn't. Welcome to my shop.
Calm down, sir.
Say, an acquaintance of mine is supposed to be holed up in an office overlooking the Royal Conservatory. Check on them if you're headed that way. I'd check myself, but the streets are locked down. I'd make it worth your time.
No, think about it.
See anything you like? Come in. Always a delight to see you.
I don't have any fucking money. Yay.
Please, visit again soon.
If you won't play along,
you're the worst thug I've ever seen. Pirate Betty, my ass, you couldn't scare a seagull.
These two whiny little bitches. I swear one of them just sounded like they died.
Made a movie, tragic death. You're a far better actress than I am.
Who opened this door?
Maybe the wind or something.
Sleepy. Gotta get to bed earlier. Disgusting.
Where is the nearest thing? 166. Sure, we'll go to that shrine, sure. Once we get two bone jar or two thingies out of that. Oh, I am blind as a bat. So my some of my powers may be different from the last like four videos. So yeah. Oh Jesus! I thought I wasn't gonna freeze there. This DOS fucking bitch. Oh, you sneaky cunt. Don't do that. She scared the shit out of me. Oh, don't scare a man with a knife. Okay, it doesn't end well. Doesn't end well. Right, I'm gonna go looking for bone charms and stuff, so I'll catch you up when I have found. I went to like one of the optional areas, or I went to somewhere that actually to do with the mission. So I will see you later then.
Leaving a trail of bloody boot prints across this dying city. Brianna Ashworth would have been miserable as a member of high society, forced to wed some bloated banker. Her only moments of real freedom, getting drunk at fancy balls, and slipping away to couple with strangers. It would have ended in an unhappy marriage and a late night plunge into an icy river. But just before mother and father married her off, so many years ago, she found Delilah instead. It was all highways and graveyards after that, never looking back. Vice Overseer Byrne is an ambitious man, but he believes in the Abbey's mission, protecting the good people of the Empire against the likes of us. You know he'd be happier deep down if this ended with Brianna Ashworth's head on a spike. Maybe yours as well.
Right, here's the map to the Royal Conservatory. That would be added to my journal, so.
You can't stay hidden forever.
I don't.
Check under the table.
Oh, for shit.
Bloody Howler, come here. Been choked up.
Someone went up to the roof anyway.
Just been knocked down.
Okay.
Not wherever you are.
For a while, I believe Ashworth has some connection to the occult incarnate.
Show yourself and state your name. Wait, I'll have a look over there.
The overseers are the forward face of the Abbey, but equally important are our sisters from the Oracular Order. To be direct, I suspect something is wrong within their sect.
Come on.
Some changes to the types of proclamations they've been making. Small but troubling deviations from tradition. But publicly saying anything along those lines will get me accused of heresy by my rivals within the Abbey. Is it possible that Ashworth has infiltrated the Oracular Order?
So Vice Overseer Byrne thinks Ashworth is interfering with the Oracular Order?
Yes, he does.
If true, it's another reason she has to be eliminated.
Ah, fucking penis. Sleep. I don't think you had to break that, whatever it was you broke. But okay. Right, key and that's the mob door. So let's go inside, I guess. Yeah, all the bone charms are in there, or not all the bone charms, some of the things are in there. Let's see how many bone charms things I actually have. 2. I need 6, because I want to be able to craft runes. But, I need master crafting to craft runes. Right, I'm back, sorry about that. Can't get over that. Locked from the inside.
Ashworth is somewhere inside the Royal Conservatory. I need to find out how a sword through the heart wasn't enough to kill our new Empress, Delilah.
Grave hounds for weeks she gave up. You should have seen the twisted things she made. All snouts and teeth and tails.
That's just the way it is, dear Parmelia. Delilah wears the outsider's mark, and some she can do flows down to us.
It doesn't seem fair.
Think about working your fingers raw, weaving nets, or raising cows to slaughter. Any of the gifts we receive is better than living under the root.
That's true and fine. A wise way to look at things. But it won't help Lucinda rise any higher in Delilah's favor.
What?
Night, night. It's wasted like 3 times more than I needed to, but screw it. At least they're unconscious. Don't need that bone charm. Do you want these ruins though? The prototype. Okay, what the fuck is that thing? I feel like I'm gonna be seen. Fuck those owls.
Taken away as well.
Who would want that ancient fool? Never mind. How goes the communion? I am hungry to whisper into the ears of the oracular sisters.
My influence grows. Last night, I walked through a dream with one of them, and we drank from a fountain in the town where she was born.
Vice Overseer Byrne's suspicions were right.
He continued to tinker with the lenses, thicker, thinner, more opaque. It was tiresome to watch. I still had the old lenses and cast-off parts piled in my workshop, but Jindosh finished some time ago. The rest is up to me, learning to use the machine. A tricky thing, touching the void through such a device.
Blood and biscuits. I look forward to using it myself once you're ready.
Will you visit soon?
Perhaps. Dunwall Tower is mostly in hand.
The High Overseer won't be a problem anymore. And there's the matter of my own project. I grow more excited with each brushstroke. When I come to Karnaka, we'll drink an ocean of good wine and stay tight as a boiled owl. I look forward to it. For now, I need your eyes on the Duke. At least until we have the sisters under control. There's no one else I trust. I'll reach out to you again on the morrow. Farewell.
Goodbye, Delilah, my Empress.
Okay. For fucking shite's sake. Load, come on, you can do it.
Last night, I walked through a dream with one of them, and we drank from a fountain in the town where she was born.
Vice Overseer Byrne's suspicions were right.
And this business with Jindosh won't affect things.
No, he can tell. It was tiresome to watch. I still had the old lenses and cast-off parts piled in my workshop, but Jindosh finished some time ago. The rest is up to me, learning to use the machine. A tricky thing, touching the void through such a device.
Blood and biscuits. I look forward to using it myself once you're ready.
Will you visit soon?
Perhaps. Dunwall Tower is mostly in hand. The High Overseer won't be a problem anymore. And there's the matter of my own project. I grow more excited with each brushstroke. When I come to Karnaka, we'll drink an ocean of good wine and stay tight as a boiled owl.
I look forward to it.
For now, I need your eyes on the Duke. At least until we have the sisters under control. There's no one else I trust. I'll reach out to you again on the morrow. Farewell.
Goodbye, Delilah, my Empress.
Okay. That's the Oraculum, or whatever it's called. Jesus. And onto the island, right. So that's an unpleasant sound. Oh, bone charms.
Rihanna was
busy with something elaborate just before Delilah came to Karnaca. I wanted to know what it was.
I'm teasing, Tamina. I read it too. Do you think Delilah really could have done that? I've heard the same stories about Paolo the Howler.
What you've heard about Paolo is not the same. He's a street orphan, full of tricks. But I have faith Delilah could do such a thing.
Coming back? It doesn't seem possible, that's all.
My dear Orlando, some people see doors where you and I only see walls.
Right, what did this bone charm do? Exploding bullets inflict damage over a wider area. Regenerations. Has regeneration while using dark vision. Far reach and blink consume no mana if used within a second of assassination. Your bullets inflict more damage, bullets break on impact. Let's get that one. Oh shit.
Why am I always the one who has to gather moss under a thorn? Seems like whenever it involves missing sleep, they always.
Right, let's shoot this. We can shoot the elevator. I always just shoot the elevator. There has to be something to do with that oraculum or whatever it is. But what is the question? Oh. Whatever the fuck that was sounded happy.
Going on, that's for sure. Better keep my eyes open.
Fuck off, I'm a right now. Go away. Fuck off. Oh, they're making gravehounds down here. What the fuck is... Or is it a turtle or whatever the fuck? That's like... Okay, that's a bit weird. Because it is a bit weird. It's a baboon. I don't need a key, do I? Don't do this to me. I don't need a key.
Tell me more about why Delilah can't be killed.
After Delilah fell to the assassin Dowd, her magic was lost, and the coven scattered. I made a new life in Karnaca. Then I heard her whispering from the void, leading me to the Duke, who heard those same whispers. Together we worked to bring Delilah back into the world, changing the Empire from the home of Aramis Stilton 3 years ago. Across the aisle, all of us who've been with her, Brimmore and before, we felt the magic return. Others joined. immortal. Forever. She holds Dunwall, and we've turned to corrupting the oracular order. The overseers take guidance from their prophetic sisters, and soon we'll influence their dreams and visions.
Okay. A tiny bit of sense. But flies can fuck off from about me. Right, I'm going to come back when I figure out what the fuck. When I figure out how to do the non-lethal kill. Or something. Or I progress somewhere in this bloody mission if I wasn't bloody stuck. I'm gonna go mad very quickly. Causes enemy to flee and forget blinds and moves. Where do I get the lenses?
This looks important. I wonder what it does.
Right. All of you, if you share my loyalty to Delilah and our coven, heed my words again. I was haunted by nightmares about the Oraculum. The original lenses Jindosh used in the device nearly ruined me. I felt Delilah's magic flicker and the flame she rekindled in me almost went dark, like it did after Brigmore 15 years ago. I fear another accident like that will cost me everything. My connection to the void, to magic itself. We cannot afford any more mistakes. I will study the discarded lens in my workshop, then have them destroyed. Remember that Delilah is relying on my efforts, and the Oraculum is attuned to me alone. Do not interfere with the device. Only I have a chance to control the Oracular Sisters.
If I can sabotage Ashworth's communion device, she'll be powerless.
Ta-da! Right, we have figured out how to do the non-lethal ending. But don't know how the fuck it's gonna work. But it'll be fine.
Looks like Kieran Jindosh made these alternate lenses for Ashworth's device. Now I can use them to sabotage it.
Oh, they're the body of the okay. I thought they were bodies, but I didn't know if they were bodies of the overseer or something else. go do this. Oh god. Why are you here? Scared would be seen. I just beheaded her, okay. Casual as fuck.
Now to activate it and sever Ashworth's connection to the void. All that's left to do is hit the switch, and Ashworth should be powerless.
Okay, did we do it? Okay, we're done. We can probably go now. There's just that one rune up there that we have to get. It ain't bollocks. And we can leave. And hopefully I will have done this in under an hour. Let's hope so. That was close. In the window. Don't want to run. Don't want those dogs to fucking hear me. Oh, they're magic. Does that mean all the dogs are gone too? Yes! Sir. Teakin' nice. Ow. Oh, we need to get the prototypes, that's another thing. Are all the witches gone? Apparently all the witches are gone. Ooh. Oh, well, those two witches that were over there are gone. Stasis, made a bit of a mess. Which oh, they're all unconscious. Right. Let's get out of here. Quickly. Right, let's head back to the ship.
So it's done.
Ashworth won't be a problem anymore.
Good. But Corvo, there's something else. Back when I lived in Dunwall, I did things that I'm not proud of.
You live long enough, that happens.
Yeah. But what I did is worse than most. I knew Delilah and Ashworth, bought into their bullshit, which led me down a bad road. To be honest, before all this, I thought Delilah dead. I don't want to get into it right now, but I felt like you should know. There are things I regret, Corvo.
Deception doesn't make for good allies, Foster.
Is that what you think, Royal Protector? You'll have to tell me all your secrets someday. Are you ready to leave now?
Yes, I'm ready to leave. Yeah, let's go.
Yes, let's go. Take me back to the dreadful whale.
Another step toward the Duke of Sirkonos and Delilah.
Yes, it would seem so. Yes, we did low chaos. Yay. We killed one. How did we kill a civilian? Meh. Okay, meh. We got all the runes, we got all the shrines, we're not really bothered about things. We missed a shit ton of coin and paintings and blueprints. Balls. But blueprints are hard to find. And special actions, we got the best price for the Roseboro prototype. And we got this coin in that shop too. Forever Severed Brianna's Brianna's linked to Delilah's magic, so she can't scream at us and shit. And we find the outpost that Vice Overseer Byrne was using to spy on Brianna on on Ashworth. He's using to spy on Ashworth, so so I guess that is today's episode, guys. Sorry there hasn't been any episodes lately. It's been busy with stuff and my whole save corrupting and all that fun stuff. Hope you guys enjoy. If you did, leave a like, comment down below of what you think so far, and subscribe to see more of this and any other things, random ass things I decided to do on the channel. So I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye.